In this video, I will show you how to replace thermal paste of my Acer Swift X. It's an ultrabook with 2.2 screen, Wi-Fi 6, i5 12th gen processor, RTX 3050, and a backlit keyboard. But because it is a thin and light ultrabook with these specs, it overheats on heavy CPU tasks, so I decided to replace the stock thermal paste. To open the laptop, you need to remove all 10 screws at the back, then pry out the cover by removing the locks around it using a thin card or a guitar pick. Next is we remove the fan and heat sink. We need to remove the screws holding them. Now we need to remove the old thermal paste. We will be using cotton swab with alcohol to remove them. Now it's time to apply the thermal paste. I will be using Artic MX-6 as the thermal paste on my laptop. When installing the heat pipe, make sure to follow the number indicated on the screw hole so that the thermal paste will spread evenly. Now, let's see if the laptop will boot up after the thermal repaste. And yes, it's still alive. To see if the thermal repaste is really effective, we'll do some benchmarks. First is the Cinebench to stress the CPU. The CPU throttles at 99 degrees and becomes stable. Unlike before, the CPU cannot cool down even at thermal throttle, and the laptop suddenly shuts down because of overheating. Using FF15 benchmark, we test the GPU temp and performance. And as seen on this video, temperature after thermal repaste 73 to 75 degrees, and unlike before, it reaches 78 degrees. For benchmark scores, there is an 8% increase from 3711 to 4004 points. So is it worth it to replace the stock thermal paste? I say yes, because by replacing the thermal paste, I was able to reduce the maximum temp of the laptop, and this will make the laptop last longer and perform better. Did you find the video helpful? Please like and subscribe for more videos like this one. Thank you for watching, and see you on the next video.